the Super Spring Triangle.
Hey there, stargazers. I'm James Albury, director of the Kika Silva Pla Planetarium in Gainesville, Florida.
And I'm Dean Regas, astronomer for the Cincinnati Observatory. We're here to help you find your way around the sky tonight. It's the middle of spring, and three bright stars are taking center stage.
It's called the Spring Triangle, and it's huge. Covering one-sixth of the sky, the Spring Triangle incorporates three ancient constellations. There's a lion, a herdsman, and a maiden up there.
Now, I'll be honest, it's really tough to see a lion, a herdsman, and a maiden in those stars. But even though I don't have the required imagination,
I don't know if anyone does,
the three main stars are easy to find.
And at least you'll know where these constellations live.
What are we talking about? Let's show you. Okay, we're facing southeast at 10 p.m. any night this week. We have the super wide angle view on since the Spring Triangle is huge.
If you live in a city, the three stars in the Spring Triangle might be all you can see. And there they are, 1, 2, and 3.
We'll start with the star on the far right. That's Regulus, the brightest star in the constellation of Leo the Lion. You usually start seeing Regulus early in the spring, and it shines with a blue-white light.
The star farthest to the left, and the brightest of the trio, is Arcturus. Arcturus is the brightest star in the herdsman named Bootes. If you look carefully, you'll notice that Arcturus is quite orange, a very different color than Regulus.
And the third star in the Spring Triangle is Spica, the brightest star in Virgo the Maiden. Spica is the dimmest of the three and the bluest, too.
Let's compare the three stars in the Spring Triangle to our Sun. The Sun is about 865,000 miles in diameter and lies about 93 million miles away. That's the distance light travels in 8 minutes. So we'd say the Sun is 8 light minutes away.
The Sun is dinky compared to the three Spring Triangle stars. Regulus, for example, is 3 times the diameter of the Sun, shines 288 times brighter, and is 79 light years away. So instead of 93 million miles, Regulus is more than 460 trillion miles away.
Yikes. Well, Spica is even bigger at 7.5 times the diameter of our Sun, shines 2,200 times brighter, and lies 250 light years away. That's equal to about 1.5 quadrillion miles.
And that leaves Arcturus. It is by far the largest of these stars at 25 times the Sun's diameter. Since it's an orange star, it's not as hot as the others. So while it still shines 170 times brighter than our Sun, it doesn't give off nearly as much energy as the hotter Regulus and Spica.
Arcturus is the closest of the three Spring Triangle stars, around 37 light years. But that's still like 217 trillion miles.
But who's counting? We're zoomed in on Regulus and its constellation Leo. When I connect the dots on the main stars, I guess I can see a lion sitting with his front paws stretched out. Well, it's certainly easier to imagine than a herdsman or a maiden, just you wait and see. The lion has a backward question mark for head above Regulus and a triangle for a tail. And this is supposed to be the Nemean lion that was killed by Hercules. Whew, that must have been some battle.
Now we're looking at the star Arcturus and its constellation of Bootes. Yep, Dean's right. I can't see a herdsman in these stars at all. Instead, I look for stars that make a kite shape or an ice cream cone. Then, down and to the right of Bootes, you can find Spica and the stars of Virgo the Maiden. She is often depicted as a goddess lying on her side holding a piece of wheat, the star Spica. If you can see a herdsman and a maiden in these stars, congratulations, you have an ancient Greek imagination.
So there you have it, the Spring Triangle, Regulus, Arcturus, and Spica.
And although you may have trouble seeing Leo, Bootes, or Virgo, you can appreciate these three celestial beacons for what they are.
Fascinating and far-flung stars.
Keep looking up.